Hello friends, and welcome back to my crafty space. My name is Crystal, and in today's video, I am going to be putting together a project planning process for you guys using the Cozy Story Kit from Allie Edwards. This is going to be the stories that I am going to be telling for this month's Story Kit Crush. So this month we are crushing the kit Cozy, doing our best to use up as much of this kit, if not all of it, if we can. So what I have in front of me is pretty much everything that came in the kit itself. I don't think I even opened it until I went to go and film this process today. So I've got all of those 4x6 journaling cards. I've got all of the 3x4 journaling cards. I don't believe I added on any embellishments this time. So I have the chipboard pieces that came with it. It also had some of these pleather house stickers, the word cozy, which mine actually broke, but I think I can actually just adhere it down onto a page together and you won't even know that. There were also some felt pieces that came in the kit and some plastic words with different things that relate to cozy. I am also a story stamp subscriber, so I've got the stamp set as well here on the side, and then the sticker sheet that came in the main kit. So I am going to be taking this kit and putting it into as many project ideas or project piles as I can come up with here, just using this idea of cozy. Before I get into this, I do want to show you two projects that I have already completed with this kit, but it was with the digital version because I had the digitals before I got the physicals in the mail. So I actually have two projects that I have done with this kit already, and I figure I can show you those so we can see what's already been done, and then we can carry on with planning what comes next. So the first story that I told with this kit in the past, and actually I'm going to move this little embellishment box out of the way. The first story that I told was one that went into my daughter's story album. So it's just about her being a big sister. What I did is I took one of the cards that had a bunch of floral and leaf elements on it, and I blew that card up, printed it out on some printable fabric paper, and then fussy cut all of those things out in order to make a wreath for this photo on the right side. The left side I kept pretty simple. I printed off two of the digital cards, added journaling into one of them, and then had one additional photo here with a chipboard that was just from my stash at the time. So this was the first one that I told. I also have this "We are defined by the moments we seize." That would have been a chipboard sticker, which is going to be actually right here is the chipboard sticker itself. But I printed mine on photo paper and cut it out and popped it up to give it a little bit of dimension there. So this was the first story I told with Cozy. The second story that I told with this kit was just about things that made me feel cozy. So I had a couple of selfie pictures that I grabbed here, things where there are like some sweaters and some like knit blankets and just things that are really cozy to me. I used this wooden ampersand that I've had forever. So I put on the title Comfy and Cozy, and these were digital stamps. And then these were just some of the leftover pieces from the project earlier that I added on here to give this a little bit of texture and dimension. On the right side, I added a couple more of those fussy cut elements and then put in two of the digital cards, one that's just a quote and one that I added some journaling to that just talked about things that make me feel cozy. So these were the two projects that I had already done using those digitals. Today we are going to take all of the physical product and see if we can't come up with stories to use that whole kit this month. And then I will spend the rest of the month on Fridays creating those projects to share with all of you. So let me move this out of the way and then we'll go ahead and get into the planning process. While I am planning things out, I will put you guys on fast forward and talk you through my process and my idea creation and all of that goodness. And then once we have that done, we'll slow back down before we close out for today. So let's go ahead and jump into this planning. All right, friends, we are going to get started on this planning process by going first through all of the journaling cards. So when I'm doing this, I am keeping a couple of things in mind. One is that I'm really looking for cards that have sentiments that go well together. So something like love my bed and warm and cozy are awesome together because to me, my bed is warm and cozy and I can totally tell a story about that using those journaling cards. So that is a little bit of step one here of what I'm doing. Another thing that I like to keep in mind as I'm going through this process are all of the different projects that I am working on throughout the year. So I have my project life that I would like to do a spread using this cozy kit. And for now, I'm going to put that one off to the side so you can see a small pile on the white portion of my desk there to the left. So that is going to be basically my project life pile. Then I have two story albums that are dedicated to my children. So one for my daughter and one for my son. Now, since I already have a spread in my daughter's album using this kit, it doesn't mean I can't make any more for her, but it does mean that I am trying to focus and find a story that I can tell about my son. I really love to take these story kits and try to tell at least one story for my daughter and one story for my son. The thing that I love about that is it oftentimes really encourages me to look at things in our life from different perspectives. So in this case, I'm thinking about telling a story about what cozy and what snuggling means in terms of like snuggling with my son, because that's just the age that he's at right now. And we all know that that will eventually pass. I'm sure my son is not always going to want to snuggle with me. So I'm going to take advantage of that right now and tell that story. So I've got a pile up in the upper left-hand corner there that has the word snuggle, you can see. So that is the pile that I'm setting aside for him. In addition to the story albums for my children, I also have one that's for our family in general. So for that album, I'm thinking about telling a story about my bed. So that's the one up in the upper right-hand corner where I've added the word cozy to the acrylic piece, some of those felt pieces, and that is what I'm thinking for telling a story about my bedroom and my bed. And then the one in the bottom left-hand corner, I'm thinking about telling a story about things around our home that feel cozy to me. And that could be from the stance of like just in general what feels cozy. But I also thought I could maybe bring in the five senses to that as well. And then as I was looking through this, I also remembered that I want to try and tell a story with these story kits for my niece. I'm making a baby album for my niece. And so the product that's right in the middle there on the top, you can see Rooted and Grounded in Love. Then there is a card that says Around Here with five sections to journal. I think that those will make a really awesome spread for her book. And then last but not least, I put a journaling card off to the side there. Actually, it looks like I have two more. I have one off to the side there where it just has a quote about leaving drama and focusing on things that make you cozy and make you feel love. That I really like that sentiment, and that really spoke to me as something that I could talk about in my personal pocket page notebook. I do share those spreads, but there's a lot more writing and it's definitely not as like techniquey, I want to say, as some of my other story projects. And then in the bottom right-hand corner, I set aside a few extra products to talk about my cat. And I thought it would be fun to take pictures of him in all of his cozy spots and to do a page in his traveler's notebook. I just have a one-off traveler's notebook that I put in stories every once in a while about our cat. So, or about our now one of our two cats. I think the other cat, I guess, needs a book now too, so I suppose. So once I had all of those journaling cards sort of figured out around this table spread here, the next thing I did, as you guys could see, is I went through each and every one of those embellishments and decided what story that embellishment could help me tell. Now, if there wasn't a specific story that I thought like, oh yes, this can totally help me tell such and such story, if I found that there wasn't a clear direction for that one, that sentiment or that embellishment or whatever it is went into my project life pile because I can definitely find a way to use it once I get to that week of project life. So now that I have everything separated out, I realized that I didn't have one of my 3x8 templates here. I try to have the templates in all of the different sizes so that when I go to sketch out my idea, the pages are to scale with what they would look like in the book. So I'm going to pull over this one for my niece first. And what we're going to do is just work on getting things sketched out so we can get a general idea of what I'm thinking for this spread using the product that I have set out. And then I also will give myself a few little notes to remember, you know, what in general is this page about and what kinds of journaling or what kinds of photos do I want to include in this spread. So that's the journaling that will, or the notes that I will write in the upper portion. Now for the actual design of this spread, what I'm thinking is to take the quote card and add that to the top of a 3x8 pocket that's got the two 3x4 pockets. So one will be the journaling and one will be the around here. So I guess I should say the quote and the around here. Then I'm thinking I will find some kind of pattern paper that coordinates well with these cards. I have a small stash of pattern paper. And then I will use that to create a flap on top of the other page. So the other side will be an outside of the page protector. I'm thinking about printing a photo at full size at 6x8, and then having 2 inches of it basically fold back over on itself, where it can have some pattern paper and that little chipboard piece. And then you can fold it open and have the photo with the cutout heart sentiment, the rooted and grounded in love, can go on top of the photo. So that was that one. I packaged it all up, put it in an envelope, and set that to the side for when I'm ready to tell that story. Next, I'm moving on to a story that will go into our family story album. One of the things that I thought of as I was trying to design an idea to go with all of these things is perhaps those little icons on this 3x4 card could be punched out with a 1-inch circle. And sure enough, they totally can. So I'm going to punch those out and use those as basically bullet points for my journaling for this page. I might make my journaling relate to all of them because all of those things are things that are inside of our home or things that we use on a regular basis. So that's super cool. I'm thinking I will do the, I'm going to use the stamp basically to create my own pattern paper for the top. There's a sentiment that says, this is what cozy means to me. So I'm going to take that, create a stamp pattern. And now that I think about it, the last one, I also am going to create a stamp pattern, that the one for my niece. I want to use the word snuggle and create my own pattern paper. So I'm not going to go into my stash for that. I don't know. I just thought about that as I'm talking here. But we're on this spread now. So I'm going to use the This Is What Cozy Means to Me stamp set to create my own pattern paper to add up at the top. Then I'm going to stitch some lines onto the paper. I've done this before in order to make some journaling spots for me to add my own writing into. I will handwrite it because I am trying to add more of that into my album this year. And then I will punch out all of those little, you know, the little circle pieces, add those as the bullet points, and then put the journaling next to it. The other thing I thought about was some kind of title. So I pulled out the cozy white acrylic piece here. Not acrylic. It's transparency or plastic. The white plastic piece that has the word cozy on it. It layers really well on top of that dark brown hat embellishment. So I'm going to layer those and add them on top as a title piece. The other side of the page, I'm going to add the This Is What Cozy Means to Me, stick some kind of picture in there. I will use the floral piece with the chipboard on top of that, and then put another 3x4 photo in there that will relate to the story. So that is going to be this one. Next, we're going to move on to another story that will go in, actually, this won't go in the family one. This is the one for Jonah. So the pieces I pulled out for this, one of them is the quote card that says, there is nothing like staying home for real comfort. I thought that was really cute because, you know, we're all snuggly at home here and it does feel very comfortable, very cozy. So that I'm going to put in one of the divided page protectors. Then I'm going to add the snuggle card in there and use that as a spot to add some journaling.
And then I'm thinking about what to do with that floral piece. I debated using that as some kind of border on the 6x8 page, which I also made a note to say, you know, that this is going to be 6x8 because I want it to go into a page protector. I'm trying to fill in a few spots in my story albums that are empty so that I can finish those up. And then my idea here was to take the card that says, I think it says cozy looks like, three times on those three like colored blobs. And what I want to do is I want to fussy cut them out of that card and then add them around my photo. So print a full page photo, add those onto the photo, and then I can write some journaling on top of those, if that makes sense. I did debate adding some chipboard pieces in there as well, just to give it a little bit more balance, but I think ultimately it'll be fine with just the three. If it's not, we'll figure it out once we get to the actual page later in the month. So then for the chipboard piece that says, you know, loving this snuggle or love this snuggle, I really like the contrast of having that on top of the floral card. So I'm actually going to just take that floral card, chop it into 2 3x4 cards, and then one of them will go with this project and the other one will go in with, for now, my project life pile. Which is nice because then it gives me a little, you know, it stretches that pattern card a little bit further. That's something I like to do when I have cards that come in the kits that are patterned like this, because there are not a lot of patterned cards. There are usually a lot of sentiment cards and a lot of journaling cards, but not a lot of actual patterns. So when there are, I like to take those out and really stretch them, cut them apart, and make them work for multiple spreads if I can. Okay, so now we're moving on to the next story, and this one will go inside of our family story album. This is the page where I want to tell a story about my bedroom, or, you know, my bed. So for this one, I already am starting by changing up the pages that I'm using, the page configuration, because like I said, I'm trying to fill in some extra spaces that are open right now. I have about 4 of these story albums going at the same time, of these family ones. And actually I have 3 of them. One of them is fully completed and 3 are in progress. So I'm trying to fill in those empty spaces so I can, you know, put a close on them and also film a couple flip throughs of the albums that I've been working on through the years, because they are getting really full to the point where, you know, 2 of them need to just be finished. So I am really trying to fill those in. So for this spread, I want to take a picture of my bed, and I'm just kind of drawing a rough sketch of the view that I want. I am no artist, but it does help me to have a general idea of what the photo is going to look like in order to figure out, like, where am I going to put these things on the photo so they make sense, but they also don't detract too much from the photo and or the story I am telling. So I want to take a picture from the foot of my bed looking into the wall. We've got some paintings that we hang above our wall there, or above our bed on the wall. So that's what I drew there just to represent it. And then I'm thinking I will cut out some of those hearts from the journaling card and use that in combination with the felt hearts and some of those cardstock sticker hearts to create some kind of arch that goes over top of our bed. And then in the ones that are actual journaling hearts, I will add some handwritten journaling into those, just talking about, you know, loving our bed. Then at the foot of it, I thought I could use that acrylic piece, Cozy, to create the title for the page. And then on the opposite side, I have a 3x8 space that I need to fill there. So I just took the 2 journaling cards, one that says, I love my bed, and the other one that says warm and cozy. And I'm going to add that into those page protectors, put some journaling on the warm and cozy, and basically call that one done. So this should be really fun. I'm actually debating on working on that one first here, just because I think it'll be a really fun one. And you know, why not? Go with, I always say to start with the stories that make you most excited to tell, because you're very excited to tell them, so why not? Moving on, this is going to be a story that will go inside of my pocket page notebook. Now, pocket page notebook is essentially a traveler's notebook that alternates between a white, like, regular piece of paper and then a clear pocket clear plastic pocket and then a white paper. So like in between each of your traveler's notebook spreads, there is a plastic pocket that is the full size of the traveler's notebook. I hope I'm explaining that in an understandable way. But I have a few of these and I like to use them as a more personal journaling type book. So I generally put like full page photos in there and a full page of text. And then I use the pocket in between to do something creative. So what I'm thinking I will do with this one is take a little bit of the floral card that we had cut off before and use that as borders on the top and the bottom of this page. And then in the pocket, I'm going to add the, you know, leaving drama card on one side, and the other side says worry less, love more. I thought that would be really good to have on the flip side of the pocket. And then I'm thinking I'll turn that into some kind of shaker pocket in between just to spruce it up a little bit. And the last thing I did with it, there were two tiny chipboard pieces. One says say no and one says say yes. So I'm going to use those as my jumping off points for my journaling for that day. Okay, so I think this is going to be the last one I'm going to put together here or sketch out here. This is the one I want to use to tell a story about my cat. So on the one side, I want to just take a full page photo of him curled up somewhere. So I want a picture where he is the focal point, but he doesn't take up the entire picture, which happens a lot when I take pictures of him. So I just need to remind myself, like, get a picture where, you know, he's curled up in his bed or in a basket or something like that. And then I can add the chipboard piece that says comfy and cozy somewhere on that photo. I'm not sure where yet, but somewhere. Then I want to take the journaling card that says comfy and cozy, cut that apart and use that top portion, maybe like the top inch of it, to be the title on top of this book. His book is a traveler's notebook, so traveler's notebook size page. And then I can use a piece of it at the bottom if I want. I probably won't though, because what I'm thinking of doing is creating a grid. Now, traveler's notebooks are not exactly 4 inches by 8 inches, but I can still probably figure out a way to roughly do 2x2, like photos and elements. So that gives me an opportunity to use the cat felt piece, one of the chipboard pieces, and then I can use some sections of that cozy card, cut those into 2x2s and use those in some spots in addition to some additional photos of my cat in 2x2s in all the cozy places. Also, that card, cozy card, was like muted enough that I could totally write on top of it, and those could serve as my journaling for that page. So what I'm doing here is just pulling out everything else to show you. This is what is going to go in my Project Life pocket. So we shall see once we get to this. I think I went aside to figure out what week I would be able to use this in. This helps me to know ahead of time, like what product I'm using for what week, and also gives me an idea for story lenses for that week when I am shooting my photos and all that kind of stuff. So we will stick that in the pocket here, and then I'm just going to pull everything back over, and then we'll slow back down.
All right, friends, so that completes our planning process for today. So with this cozy kit, and mind you, I had the entire kit. I had not used a single piece of this before today. So with the entirety of the cozy kit, I have a week of Project Life that I am going to put together, and then I've got 6 stories that I can tell using the product. And then I also have those 2 that I made with the digital product as well. So it'll be a total of 8 cozy stories along with 1 week of Project Life here for 2021. So the next thing I will be doing is going and finding the photos or taking the photos that I need to help me tell these stories, writing down the journaling that I want to include for all of them, and then I will set to work getting these stories told and in my books. So I will pick one of these to go ahead and put together today. That will be in a separate video. And then we can look forward to the rest of this month where I will put together the rest of these as well. I will try to get all 6 of them done if I can so that we can actually officially crush this kit in the month of February. I hope that you guys have enjoyed seeing this planning process. If you did, I would love a thumbs up on this video down below. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button so you can see all of the future crafty videos, including all of these stories coming your way in the future. I will be back with another video today, and then again next Monday with a story for one of my story albums. So hopefully I will see you guys back here then. Until then, have a great rest of your day, a fantastic weekend, and I will catch you all in the next video. Bye now.